makes sense.
Brayden, I missed you.
So who's talking about getting fucked?
My cat.
Yeah, his cat's his cat likes to antagonize his other cat and just be like, try and fuck me. You don't want to fuck me.
So he's a Siamese Himalayan mix, so he's a big boy. And the cat, and
they, fixed. They don't shut up.
No.
Yeah.
Oreo, she's the youngest one, but she isn't fixed and is constantly tries to get him to mount her. And he gets annoyed by it and picks a fight with her, and it just doesn't go well.
Dude, what a fucking mood.
Yeah. Fucking trying to get to, you know, trying to get me to mount, and I don't want to mount, and it's like, what the fuck, dude?
It's like when you go to mount, but you look down, and your balls are gone.
This is pointless!
Madness. Oh god, what am I?
A freak!
That reminds me of when Aaron was just really mad at the Mario Maker level. And yeah. He yells that at the top of his lungs. He's like, you're just a freak!
Freak! You're a freak!
Like, I know, but you didn't have to be so mean about it.
God damn. God damn.
Calm down.
Welcome back to Hard Homies Podcast, everyone, by the way.
Yeah, okay. Thanks. I appreciate it.
No, holy shit, that's like four of them in a row.
Wait, no. Brayden was supposed to do it, goddammit. Reroll. Oh. Yeah.
That's right, redo it. Brayden, come on.
Yeah. Go ahead.
What? You blew your load prematurely and you expect me to be next up on the train?
Close enough. Okay, we'll roll with it.
You have to be so disappointing that me going prematurely is worth it.
I am going to get a clip of you saying welcome back to Hard Homies Podcast. I'm just going to clip it over you saying that.
Welcome. The homies are hard.
Yes.
There we go. Perfect. Yeah.
There you go. You can clip that, flip that around, do whatever you need to do, big boy.
Butcher it as hard as you can. I want you to just ruin the whole setup for the phrase, even though it will be anyway, but you know.
Yeah. Oof. How butchering do you want it to be?
Pretty goddamn butchering.
How to what effect?
There's a kitty.
Is Oreo. Her heart's beating 1,000 miles an hour because I don't ever hold her, so she's kind of freaking out right now.
Because of the
cat. Wanted her to say hi. Let go of my mouse pad. Go, bye.
Is that cat cocaine?
She's so fast. She's like, you don't hold me. Put me down now.
You don't hold me. You don't hold me, bitch. I hold you.
You ain't trying to fuck me. How dare you?
So you know how cats, when you pet them, they refer to that as they think they're dominating you when you do that. I don't know if you guys knew that.
I was going to say, like, the cats refer to it as...
Yes.
Or, like, what?
So, you know, because the cats are always stuck up and higher. Anyway, it was... That being said, I have always wondered, because I'll sometimes pet Monty with my foot, and he gets really mad about it. So I wonder if it's a sign of disrespect to him.
Probably. Well, he's like, no,
you're touching him with your foot. Hands. I think that's a sign of disrespect in most cultures, not just cat.
Yeah, I guess it would be pretty rude if you start going up to somebody, you start petting them with your feet.
I'm pretty sure you'd be
you'd get a handshake with like your foot out, you know, like
okay, that's
like, yeah, that'd be kind of fucking weird, right?
the only time that's a reasonable thing to do is if you're missing your fucking arms.
And then
actually, here we go. There are cultures where shaking with your left hand is a sign of disrespect. So which is more disrespectful, left hand or foot?
Foot. Easy foot.
Yeah, because that shit's nasty.
Yeah, 90%. If someone like gave their foot to me, I'd fucking beat them.
Like, if you are, if so, so you don't have arms. And no offense to anyone who actually doesn't. If they somebody is,
you're not a fan. You're not.
If you can't, if you can't, if you can't click the donation button, we don't care about your opinion.
I was trying to save myself, and you guys just dug it harder. Thanks, appreciate that.
You guys, you know who can't dig holes?
Oh, people that fucking hands.
Kind of a shitty thing of you to say, Brandle.
And my whole thing there is they get used to using their feet.
Dig, huh?
No, no, but they get they get used to using their feet. But yeah, that means they regularly clean and wash their feet too. Everyone else who has arms does not. I guarantee it, unless you're getting in the shower or what, you know, that kind of thing.
You do not
speak for yourself, you gross son of a bitch.
In the shower and fucking scrub your feet.
Oh yeah, of course. But no, I'm saying
like who doesn't do that? Who was taught like, oh my god, like,
you just out yourself? Like, do you just out yourself? Do you got some stank ass feet, boy? Do you not wash your feet in the fucking shower?
But I mean, like,
I remember his feet in high school. That shit was rank, bro. Like, that was bad. God.
You took it. That's why 9 times out of 10, I just.
I'm remembering and I'm gagging right now. That's how bad
it is. Yeah, I was thinking about his feet gagging a little bit.
Is it on par with you blowing up the bathroom then? Is that where it's at?
No, not even close.
No, nothing is. Yeah.
Damn.
No, dude, that was disgusting. That was like
Brandle, when I think back to the time in high school where you assaulted us with your feet stench, I didn't get emotional empathy readings from the smell.
Yeah. Okay.
Did we ever talk about this?
Did I just shove this in the back of my head? Did you guys ever, you know, say something?
Oh, like say something to
you? Yeah.
No, yeah, we fucking did multiple times, man. Are you kidding me? Like,
I just
looked at us like cold, like dead, like dead in the eyes, man.
And then you like got the Domino's garlic parmesan sauce and you just started like pouring it onto them for some reason.
Oh man. Okay. Well,
yeah, I actually do have like a vague memory of something like that happening. I'm not
even fucking. It was the same night that he gave the foot job to the Little Caesar's crazy bread.
Yeah,
that's right, because he was garlic lubing up his feet because he was prepping the crazy bread.
Yeah, right. Because we picked up from two different pizza places, right? Because we wanted the crazy
that's
bread.
Normal part of the crazy story.
Well, I think the crazy bread we also got for like $1 or something like that. Because it's
right high school. In the day when they
because they used to give out the little coins that was like free bag of crazy bread.
Hey, do you not remember that? Yeah, we did that all the time.
Brandle like spent 45 minutes. Making noises while we just refuse to acknowledge him in the corner.
Yeah. Can't even just touch the
Leave me in the corner with my Domino's and bag of crazy bread.
We tried to, but like you would keep going.
So give me.
Hey,
look at me.
It's because we kept running out of soda. Okay. You know, I need my 4 12 packs a day. Oh my God. No.
It was like you asking Tyler, I need my Jesus juice, and Tyler going like second and just opening up 6 packets of random ass flavors.
Oh dude, it worked every time. It tasted great. This shit was fire.
We treated it like Kool-Aid flavors, and you go, what flavor did you make?
Purple. Red.
Dude, there were so many conflicting flavors in that thing. The only description could be the color.
I remember one time we got it so green that it like tasted like fucking green apples. It was pretty baller.
Which is weird because you had nothing getting close to apples.
Oh, I know. It was like lemon, and then it was like raspberry, some other like tropical thing, and like for some reason it ended up with the flavor of green apple.
And it was like brown.
No, it was like a green brown. Not appealing to look at.
But no,
that's what I mean. We drank it anyway.
Oh yeah, and we fucking killed it in like an hour, I'm sure.
Oh yeah.
Well, because the amount of sugar in that bitch was enough to give a dopamine rush to a clinically depressed bitch. It was zero sugar,
man. We only used Crystal Light.
They were like on crack, though. That shit was so good.
Yeah,
like,
there's a bunch of caffeine in it.
That's probably why. That's probably why.
Yeah. That actually tracks a lot. I didn't realize it had caffeine.
Yep. This entire story checks out.
And then we'd make another one in like 2 hours and go down that one within the hour too.
God damn. Yeah.
Then we start getting like fucking chocolate wasted and fucking trying to recreate epic meal time.
I think Connor really liked chocolate milk.
Both my brothers. Are you kidding me? Yeah. Both love chocolate milk.
Oh yeah,
dude. Like I survived off of chocolate milk in boot camp. That shit good.
But do you guys like that Hershey syrup, or do you guys get a different brand? Because I don't care for the Hershey's brand because I don't like the bitterness, like the semi-sweet chocolate that's used for it. That was my whole reason for bringing that up.
Oh, dude, I go straight for dark chocolate every time.
Really?
Interesting. Yeah. Like, if I want, like, milk that's just overly sweet, have you ever had banana milk?
Yes, that shit's delicious.
That shit's fucking good. Like,
yeah.
I'm one of the psychopaths that think, like, the artificial banana flavor is great.
Yes, it's so good, like in the runs and stuff. Really? Yeah. No, Tyler.
No.
No, Tyler, I'm going to stab you right here.
What the fuck is wrong with you guys? The artificial banana flavor? Oh, that is disgusting.
Dude, it's
the
good.
Greatest flavor I've ever had on good. This planet, dude.
Are you kidding me? Like, do you remember those like little banana, they're yes. like the hard candies?
Yeah, the
banana runs.
Those were so good. Or the banana Laffy Taffy?
Absolutely awful.
Yes, the banana Laffy Taffy had probably some of the strongest banana flavor ever.
Dude, it was good. It was like my favorite flavor for a while. It's
the best one. You're fucking crazy.
Fuck you guys. My God. God damn. We always had fresh bananas at my house. Why would you ever eat the artificial one? Are you kidding me?
We ate because you kept shoving the real ones in my mouth.
That's right.
Oh, that's true. Yeah.
To be fair, you did that whole thing with Brayden. So that's fair.
Well, to the point where it became like an actual fucking like, learned beverage.
Did you ever get that corrected, Brayden?
Or did you don't know. Did your girlfriend?
Has Emily tried to do it to you yet?
No.
Does she know?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
She knows. Out of respect, she won't do it?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's good.
You know, that's so sweet of her.
No, she's probably saving it.
Yeah, probably. Yeah. Oh, dude, she's going to be a fucking dildo.
I was going to make a nasty comment, but I'm not going to save that for somebody.
Can we get the lube that's flavored like banana?
Yeah,
the artificial banana flavor lube.
You can have that one, Brayden. That's all yours, buddy. Oh, but yeah,
I'm actually pretty certain there are condoms with that, like, flavoring.
No, there's like actual flavored lubes that have it.
No, I had a Trojan banana flavored one, and like a cherry, and like an apple, and like back in like high school and shit.
So you can get your dick stuck while it's in rubber for some reason. I don't know, it's kind of weird.
Yeah, it is.
Right, like,
I never quit.
That's for the hookers, right? That's like for the whores, like when they're because you're like, I'm not certain where your mouth's been, so
there you go.
Put on some rubber.
To be fair,
that's when you whip out the Trojan fire and ice.
Oh my god,
sure. To be fair, that back be in high fire. School, when I had those, I just used it as like, hey, a gimmick, as like, hey, I have these flavored ones.
Well, you know, it's an easy way to get a little more ass, you know? Like,
you want to go try it out? Like? And obviously the rest of the people around that time were going like, yeah, of course, sure.
Yeah, just, man, I'm oblivious. Down, whatever.
Yeah, dude.
You have to, He's like, I'm going to pop it in your ass and make myself a sundae. And they're like, yes, it's more. I'm Mormon. And that's good thinking because God can't see it.
Oh, it's weird living in a different state. I'm sure you've noticed that, Tyler, just the difference, like culturally growing up wise, how much of the Mormon has a chokehold of the Utah state.
Yeah, and that's why all of the girls there like the beach show.
Oh, that's right. But yeah. Michaela grew up that way. I grew up that way up until I was like, I don't know, 13, 14, before I was like, okay, no, this ain't for me.
Yeah.
You're like, nah, dude.
Nah. I was awkward and shy about it. I just stopped showing up. And then, you know, they'd come by, check on you. And like, hey, how's it going? We haven't seen you in a while.
We heard that you just started working.
Yeah, that too.
Oh my God. Get back to that someday.
Yeah. Well, there's something that we need to bring up. It's something that Brayden showed us a little bit earlier today, and disclaimer, we're disappointed in Brayden. We don't condone his actions. But like most men nearing the age of 30 and not certain what to do with money, he's fallen into the supple allure of dogfighting gambling.
That was taken out of context.
Yeah, it was there in black and white.
That was taken out of context.
We condone it. Brayden, we need to ask
both of those dogs volunteered.
Oh, they consented. No one was
forcing them.
They just put each other in front of each other and were throwing money and saying fight. Come on.
Who won? I'm just curious.
Money wise, or that there was any money.
Yeah. Who walked away being a winner?
Yeah.
Both of them. Both.
I feel like it was crippled. I feel like it was a little one sided. Like it was a setup fight. Like your big ass dog against the tiny little.
Excuse me.
Dog was fucking huge in that fight, man. That was disgusting. He didn't even show the whole video because I was positive the rest of it was just your dog ripping that other dog in half.
It was like a Rottweiler attacking a little rabbit.
It was not a Rottweiler attacking a rabbit. It was literally a Malamute and a Pitbull. It was a Malamute and a Pitbull just having fun. Wrestling a bit.
Are you proud of yourself?
Yeah, I got $20. Why wouldn't I be?
$20.
Fuck yeah! That's what we do it for. That's what we do it for, guys.
That's what we do at HH.
We call that seed money. We invest it back into the company.
Exactly.
Oh, by the way, you probably want to transfer the rest into an offshore bank account because we may be getting audited. I don't know why, though.
Oh, that's convenient.
That's good for you.
It's good for you. This is where I just, you know.
Yeah, so. He's trying to hit that. No, I was not involved.
I was never here. We have not done this.
Shock to me. I'm sure you guys have seen the videos taken in public places. All dogs are happy to be there, but every day at around 6:30, he's 10 people who take their dogs out and all the dogs are just running around and wrestling and shit.
Mm-hmm.
And it's cute as fuck, but my dog has started doing something weird, right?
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Now, I don't know where she learned this, but she has decided that she wants to do jujitsu.
And kill off the competition.
No, no. Like, that would be a worthwhile use of jujitsu. But okay. She's like first Don, where she thinks everything has to start off with her on her back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then just scoots like, come on. Like crab walks, basically.
I'm not even shitting you, yes. Like, she's like, a dog will come up and she'll like give them kisses. The other dog will give them kisses, and then that like initiates it. And then she just flips over on her back.
Like, okay, who's ready to fight me? Let's go.
No, that's literally it. That's literally it. And that's then
hilarious.
There's like three dogs, and they're all just one of them, I swear to God, is doing some capoeira.
Flips. Just
yeah.
Jokes aside, isn't that actually like a form of like a dog domination or like endearment? Because they're exposing their belly trying to play with the other dogs.
I don't know.
It probably is, but
probably.
I don't know. I feel like I've heard something similar about that. Because I know that's what cats do in a similar way, because they hate their having their belly touches. My cat loves it, and obviously if she can do that, she trusts you. Monty, you cannot touch his belly at all. Don't even fucking try.
But can I touch your belly?
Yeah. And it's fucked up that it doesn't go both ways, isn't it?
You don't find touching my belly as satisfying as touching yours. You have to admit.
Well, yes, but see, now they're, you know what I was just telling you earlier, how they were fighting over Oreo trying to get laid over here? It's happening right now.
It's happening right now.
Are you filming a cat porn video?
No.
Oh god.
Dude, we're gonna get age restricted. We just barely started making money off of Tyler's fucking channel.
It did start making money, that is correct. So
why are you pulling your phone out? Why are you pulling your phone out?
Hey, he's gonna snap it. Yes.
Dude, this
Well, I expect that from all of my granny cat porn videos. It's just very
Dude, it's a small niche. Yeah, it's a small niche. You have to take what you can get sometimes.
Don't mind my very cluttered apartment, because that's what you can see. You can't see the cats when I zoom in on them.
Oh, God.
Okay. Oh, my God.
Oh, yep. Yep.
Oh, God.
I can see Oreo ready to go.
Yeah. Mm-hmm, yep. You're welcome for that. You got your
thank you.
What an evolution, where we started with Monty and Oreo being the thumbnail, and fame has gone to their heads.
Oh my God! Can we release it like the RJ and Kim Kardashian sex tape?
Yes, please.
Like,
no objection.
Be on the cover of Vogue.
Can we just name it the Kim Kardashian leaks sex tape, and it's just like right up.
Yes. Wait, hold on. Did you guys? You should save that replay, Tyler.
Oh, dude, no, I'm not doing it. That's gross.
Yeah, you fucking disgusting bastard.
You know what? I'll upload it as like a short feed.
Coming out here accusing me of participating in a violent sport that I do not condone. Meanwhile, you're over here filming some fucking snuff.
It's not snuff.
Porn.
Not snuff. No one's dying.
Yet.
So, I'm going to be honest with you. I think that picture, that video was low quality enough. I don't think you could tell anything that was.
Yeah, no, I couldn't see anything. I could just barely see like Oreo arch makes, and it, as you zoomed in.
That makes your imagination.
Oh.
Well, Brandon just
imagination is going to show you the monster to the last.
Whoa! Did he like catch up for you there?
Yeah, he did. Yeah, like fast forwarded through all of his dialogue.
No, yeah. It's okay because it wasn't important anyways.
Well, that's good. Well, yeah.
Yeah, you guys are doing the speed running. You're just talking to the quest giver.
Yeah, no, that's
what we do here. Genuinely know wanted to know what you were saying.
Actually, yeah, something about you going and fetching me 20 slimes.
Slimes?
Would you put slimes? Yeah, we have to go kill the slimes, and then he's gonna give us a reward, and he's gonna tell us our prince is in another castle.
Yeah, but like you're level one. You're level one, so you have to go get me some slimes.
Mm-hmm. Am I also a slime?
No.
Am I reincarnate in night?
No. Okay, that shit's
going No, we're never fucking. We're never talking about isekai again.
Unless you watched? Did you finish Konosuba? Because I finished solo leveling. Okay, God fucking damn it, Brandle. I watched all of Solo Leveling. The thing you can do for me.
Okay, I promise I will finish and get. That's a lot more watching though, but
it's 11 episodes.
Skipping my dialogue, motherfuckers.
Yeah, because when does season 3 come out?
Sorry.
No, you're good.
It's already out.
Yeah. Oh, is it out?
Episode 2 just dropped today. God damn it!
Okay,
Brayden, I apologize, man. I said I'm sorry.
Did you kick him out? Okay.
Oh, I didn't kick him out.
Oh.
You didn't I can. You know, I can just...
That may have been me.
Oh, did you... Can't he do the same thing to us?
Yay, come back. He's here. Yeah, you're here. You're alive. Brayden, I may or may not have accidentally kicked you.
Accidentally?
Yeah.
Quote-unquote.
Mm-hmm. Someone hit that pause down skip cutscene.
The first disconnect actually wasn't me. The second
one was... No, that one was me.
Just wanted to make it clear. I didn't do it twice.
Some reason, someone told the cops about the dog play group. Oh. And they just
we reported it as soon as we saw it, you know?
We're like,
what the fuck?
So we didn't condone it, man. Like, it's
what
fucked
the
up.
Fuck?
The animal abuse! Asshole!
Didn't even say anything to me first?
First of all, it was your fault for streaming it. You literally... Yeah.
I didn't know! I accidentally hit the button!
Come on, man. You know what Michael Vick did. Everyone knows what Michael Vick did.
My dick wasn't even out, guys.
Oh, man. For those of you who don't know who Michael Vick is, just Google him.
You get no context. We usually derail into context, but this time you don't get it.
Yeah, no, this...
Usually it's like context for like something that happened 45 minutes ago.
And it was like a sliver of what we were trying to get a point to.
It's been kind of fucked up because of all the concussions, though. So, you know, it might not be all his fault. Some of the dog deaths are also on the NFL.
NFL? More like the ATF.
Oh, God. Anyways.
Did you hear about the dog that got sent out into outer space? And it just died because it kept running in place and gave itself a heart attack.
Dude, Russia, man.
What were you going to say, Tyler?
No, I wasn't going to say anything.
Yeah, you're going to go,
he's like, wait a minute. If I say anything, I incriminate myself as part of the experiment.
Yeah, I'm secretly the AD.
Yeah, you guys heard about this, haven't you?
No. God. I'm gonna say like Tyler was the treadmill.
I probably was. Let's be honest.
You've had some nights. Treadmilling.
Oh my god, I have had some nights.
Dude, those nights.
Spooky nights, man.
Brayden, it's 2:00 in the morning. I'm at the train station walking around. Can you come pick me up? I'm scared.
It was really scary, Brayden. It was really scary. And I had just gotten over fucking diaper lady, okay? Like,
diaper lady.
I was like, yeah, man, it's all right. I'm on my way. Just stay put. It'll be okay. And I pick you up. And it's like, what? Is someone chasing you? Is someone about to fucking...
No, but never dealing with age play again. Disgusting. Disgusting.
Did I meet this person?
No, you never met this
person. No, you're thinking of another diaper-wearing bubble baby.
Yeah. I was just thinking of...
This is when I was in the BDSM community. So
Tyler, you were finding yourself, brother.
No, I was
He was looking in some weird places if he was trying to find himself.
That's true. You were like on a high for a minute off of it. You were like, okay, guys, I got a new plan. I got something else set up here. We're fucking.
Well, dude, there's a whole ass community in Utah, man. And it's huge, too.
Well, that's what happens when you fucking are part of the church your whole life and you're a miserable fuck.
Yeah, true. I mean,
and then you're like, what part of that life am I signing up for today?
How much you want to bet at more than half of the people that are part of that community actively are going to church?
Oh, I doubt that, honestly.
But doesn't really that make that. It kinkier?
Exactly.
I bet you there. I wouldn't say it's half. I would say it's probably like
3/4, you're right.
No, way, 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 way less. Like maybe a 16th are actively going. And
then, 5/11.
Brayden.
Wait, you were talking about like a proportion of the people there.
No.
What the fuck are you thinking about?
I don't know. I just,
you know. Like,
no. Yeah. You had to whip out the numbers, but no, it's like a 16th, like if anything is my guess. This is back like when I was a part of it, so who knows, it might have grown, there might be more now, but
maybe. Who's that?
Whose butt pluck is going off?
You hear that buzz. Oh, I
no, he doesn't.
We're just adding to it. I'm sorry, Tyler.
No, it's all good. It's all good. Man.
Fun fact, my pop filter broke, by the way.
Oh, shit.
I literally picked it up off my desk because it was.
I can't hear a word that you're saying.
Dude,
I just muted myself.
Oh, yeah, there you go, yeah.
Thanks. I'm sorry. Anyway,
I have two pop filters. Do you want one?
No, I just need to go buy a new one. This one really is, it's like a plastic one. It doesn't have any, like, cloth to it.
Yeah, I have two of them. One of them is wrapped around the mic like a condom, and then the other one is wrapped in front of it like the Subway sandwich sneeze guard.
You guys want me to sound treat your rooms? Like, I'll just like fly out to you guys, and well, I guess like both Brandle, I don't want me to fly to you, but Brayden.
I was gonna say, hold on, homie, I'm coming out like next week.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
I was gonna say, like, I have shock mounts, I have all the stuff to make it better. I just don't have shit on the walls except for the snake.
Well, the walls are pretty important. And then if you have
your walls there, feel great, by the way.
No, they are great, honestly, because it deadens the noise in here. I already did the test.
Dude, something died in there.
Really, though, it's like impressive.
Man, your colon is legendary.
It is. Yeah. No, like. People should know.
dude, you should like post it online. You should like spread it.
They should run for president, to be honest. Like, my colon for president.
Dude, you should like go to yourself and post it online, like as a joke. It'd be funny.
It would be pretty funny, yeah.
You could just say that you're cosplaying as a Tears of the Kingdom shrine.
Can you get an x-ray of your kidney? Is that how that works?
What?
A CT scan or whatever. Fucking.
I don't even know what the fuck we were talking about, to be honest.
Your kidneys?
Why?
I want a picture of your kidneys, Tyler.
Why?
I'm a little scared.
I had a reason to this.
Okay. That's what is the reason? Because that's not something people usually say.
Because yeah. Tyler wanted to spread her awareness, so I wanted a picture to...
about my fucking colon, not my kidneys.
Colon. I'm sorry.
Did you get colon and kidneys mixed up? Because yeah, those are two very different functions.
Dude is trying to find out if you're still pumping out adrenochrome or something.
Either way, it still applies. Picture, propaganda.
Of my colon or of my kidneys.
Both of them wouldn't show up in an x-ray.
The premise is I need a picture of dead colon. Then I can just...
I can get you an ultrasound of it.
There you go.
Dude, the spaghetti is falling out of your pockets. Listen,
I'm going to have to get my prostate checked soon anyways. So, like,
get a picture of that, too.
And, like, the doctors are, you know, doing that. I'll have them send me the recording.
And I'd be the doctor.
We'll live stream it.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, that'll be a live stream. It's just like hard homies. Tyler gets his ass checked.
Tyler goes to a proctologist.
Okay, guys, I had to pay off my doctor to do this, but this is for you.
Don't you guys love it when during your exam you feel the doctor's reassuring hand on your shoulder? Ooh, and then the crippling fear when you feel his other hand on your other shoulder.
And he has a little bit of a too much of a tight grip on your shoulders.
That's pulling your hair.
And it just keeps getting tighter and tighter and tighter.
You bite the pillow and you're just like, this is happening.
Nah, you don't even get to bite the pillow. You're still standing up, but your face is getting smushed into the wall.
Oh, God.
Nurse is off there in the corner. Like,
at that point, I hope
we must update his file.
Typing away at the computer, just not even looking.
Yeah, like screaming. Yeah, like a medical resident. It's like, I need to take the whole notes. Thing,
the whole time, just recording, and then they save it as an official document for medical use.
Oh my God.
Brother, I live on a med school campus. I would not be surprised. Some of these people do not know how to survive real life.
Oh no, that's terrifying. But I don't hope they wouldn't need to learn how to.
Dude, this is...
How autistic is everyone there? Like, just like be honest. I'm curious. Is it like pretty noticeable that like 80% of them?
What?
Is that they have to take a class about the foundations of empathy.
So pretty goddamn autistic.
I see.
Dude,
well, I simply could answer that with, well, that's probably why they have a favorite crayon color to eat. The best flavor.
Hey, that's cultural appropriation. You can't take fucking crayons away from me.
The Marines have some empathy. Like, well, you know.
I figured that's what we were talking about, since that's what Brayden was the part of.
What do you think? I live at a med school campus. No, what did you think that was code for?
What did you think that was code for? You're a fucking boot still. You're going to wake up tomorrow and you're going to get yelled at to do a 2-mile jog.
All right, yeah, that's my fault for me.
No, this is real. Fucking, you've been in a coma. You got to wake up.
A fucking helo flew over last night. I was like,
Oh, shit.
I'm sorry, Brayden. I shouldn't make assumptions like that.
I signed up to fight for my country, and all I got was a fear of fireworks.
You get scared
in a stupid t-shirt.
Do you get scared when you load up Helldivers, Brayden? You get scared?
It's like fear boner, you know?
You get to
Games different, but like when it's like actual, like real auditory noises that like imitate what those sound like in real life, it's a bit different, right?
Oh,
like,
yeah, boy. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Because like it's unexpected almost outside, but like
no, when I load up a video game, like
right.
I have control, I know the full context.
Mm-hmm.
Right? I have a say in it.
Mm-hmm.
Helicopter flies overhead, and I hear crack, 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 and I'm like,
oh, fuck.
Yeah, a little unsettling. A little nerve-wracking.
No, dude, it goes way beyond that. It goes way beyond that.
I don't think I could handle it, to be honest.
Dude, I talked to my psychiatrist about it, and she was like, okay, I'm just going to give you these. Look at the label, and it's like, oh, this is a surgery sedative.
Oh, boy. That's fun.
He gave me like 60 of them, and I'm like, what the fuck am I supposed to do with this?
Yeah.
Next week was 4th of July. I'm like, okay, never mind. Just pop a few, go to bed.
Howdy. Howdy 5K.
And you're ready for the next day, boy.
My dad shows up. My dad shows up, and I'm like, Dad, shut the fuck up.
Mm.
Oh, boy.
Did you ever have any pleasant dreams when you were there, Brayden?
Dude, I don't think I've had a pleasant dream since.
Yeah, that's fair.
That's goddamn.
I'm right there with you.
Dude, basically how it works is I lay down, I close my eyes, and I open my eyes, and it's morning.
Mm-hmm.
Fuck, apparently all you have to do to have like crazy ass dreams is do shrooms, because ever since I did the 8.6 grams, it's been nonstop, just fucking visual ass dreams. I'm talking like crazy ass dreams for me.
Dude, you should drink like a couple of apple juice before going to bed.
I have been actually. Like,
that's why you've been having crazy ass dreams.
Well, no, I've been doing it to enhance it.
It has nothing to do. Or no, it might have something to do with the mushrooms because
Yeah.
Random neurons firing and getting translated, whatever. But apple juice contains synapses.
Yes.
Yeah.
In the brain pathways. So like now my brain's just, it works different, which I've noticed it definitely does.
Yeah. Are you telling me that you're built different?
No, my brain is just now different after that trip. I'm not even kidding you. I feel very different.
Is that a bad thing or do you think it's a good thing?
No, this Tyler's a good Tyler.
Is it? Well, you know what I mean.
So it's like no work and all play makes Tyler a good boy.
Mm. I like
that. Oh, yeah. He's a good little boy.
I'm glad I have one ear off.
Yeah, yeah, that's right.
I'm glad I have both in.
No, yeah, it's I feel different, but like I feel good. And it just good. But the dreams, man, the dreams have been nonstop, just like they feel almost prophetic in a weird way, because it simulates real life so goddamn well. Like it feels like it's real life.
Well, if it becomes an issue, which I doubt it, just take some gummies, like some edible gummies. It'll help reduce that.
Yeah, dude, I've had shuts off almost.
Yeah,
dude, I've had a Rawson gummy in my nightstand for the past 4 months because I took a look at the labeling. I'm like, dude, I'm scared of this thing.
You should be, Rosin. Oh my god.
Dude, it's called Clockwork Orange, and the picture on it is just the Stanley Kubrick movie poster. I'm like, this thing scares me.
Ah, damn. Okay, that is terrifying.
I'll send you a picture of it. I'll send you a picture of it, but it was like, because we were going to the dispensary because they're around every corner here. And I'm like, I like these ones. I take one, I feel happy, I chill out. And there's like, you want a free sample of something?
Oh, God.
I'm like, sure. And they're like, here you go, pick from the box. And I grab it. And it's like, oh, live Rawson.
Yeah.
I think I've learned from my mistake of just never letting people give me random drugs again. But.
It was state issued.
You rode the line doing it with that one guy, apparently, though.
Fucking never doing that again. Oh my god.
Yeah.
Never.
Third time's the charm, right?
No. Well, third time. You can mean that was the one time. So.
That means you got to do it two more times, then, right, Tyler?
No.
Never again.
That's how you know the hero's dose changed him.
Yeah, when you don't want to do it again.
You're like, yeah. I think I'm good not recreating that experience.
Yeah, very good. Very good.
Having no sense of reality to ever try to grasp yourself a part of.
Holy shit, I needed someone sober and someone that I could trust there.
You really did. Like, him doing it with you was like, no.
Bad idea. Bad idea.
Bad idea. Look, a good trip sitter, right? All of you listening, if you want to take one for the team and be your trip sitter for the night, put on either Avatar, like the blue people one, or Into the Spider-Verse. Turn off the lights, distribute water and snacks, and hand everybody like beads to make necklaces. They will chill out for 12 hours, make 40 candy necklaces, and it'll just be good vibes.
I feel like if I'm taking a hero's dose, though, and I'm watching Into the Spider-Verse, I'm going to fucking freak the fuck out. And
oh, no, no. Like,
no, yeah, you don't want to freak out, man. I'm telling you right now, but yeah. I mean, just based off of my trip, fucking best thing that you can do is have someone sober there.
Yes.
And have someone who's not going to freak out when you start acting weird and maybe going a little crazy and losing your mind, because you will forget who you are.
Right.
The best part is, like, you're over there experiencing ego death and you're describing it to me. I'm like, bro, I don't even know if that was your fault.
No,
like, obviously, big. Like, obviously it's not your fault, because it's going to show you what you want to show you. But I'm like, I don't think you were the one responsible for the bad headspace that was created there.
Exactly. Especially with his kind of energy being pulled into with you. It just.
Yeah. And, you know, for me, I was just like anxious. But then I only started getting anxious after a certain little bit.
Once you start seeing the colors.
Yeah.
The people colors, you know what I mean now?
Yeah. But yeah, it was fucking, it was crazy, man. I learned a lot. I learned a lot. Just if you're going to do a hero's journey, have someone sober with you for the love of God.
Someone that you trust.
And or be fucking alone in a padded room where you can't hurt yourself.
No, because you are getting way too close to the LSD dark room experiment. Be careful about that.
Yeah.
Speaking of animals that are wanting to fuck right now, do you hear that?
You dog?
No, it's the fucking lizard.
No, the lizard.
I think only you can hear that. I think your mic does a good job of cutting that out.
God damn, because he's like screaming it.
He's screeching, just like, fuck me.
Goodbye.
No, he's going, fuck you.
Fuck you. Fuck you. Boys. Yeah,
I can't.
I actually have to leave a little early today.
Are you going to poop?
I have some secret things I need to work on.
Are you gonna like poop right now?
I'm probably gonna go shit myself. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Cause I just ate some like buffalo chicken tenders and my tummy has been making a rumbly.
Oh, so you also need shit.
Randall, are you gonna poop?
You need shit,
only in the name of the podcast and for a friendship with you guys.
Dude, you should like totally take a poop in front of us. And turn it into wine. Turn that poop into wine. Turn that poop into wine. Turn that poop into wine.